Ahoy ahoy and welcome to Skincare with Lenka. Today's topic is microneedling. I will be talking about microneedling and later I will also show you microneedling in action. I will microneedle my face, neck and décolletage. Quick disclaimer before we start. This is not an instruction video. I'm simply sharing my experience with you. I'm also not a dermatologist or a professional, and this video is made for educational and entertainment purposes only. I would like to remind you that if you buy your favorite products through my links, you will support me and my channel at no additional cost to you. You can find all the links and necessary information down below in the description box. If you would like to try microneedling, you should go out first and get this book. This is Microneedling for Aestheticians and Beauty Therapies by Nikki Pierce. You will find all the necessary information you really have to know before you start. You can find the link down in the description box. So as you can see, I love to highlight everything. In the beginning is lots of biology, which is a little bit hard, and I had to use Google for like every second word to explain what it's basically talking about. But you don't need to know it perfectly. It's just explaining the science behind the microneedling. So what is happening actually in the skin. So that's why I think this book is really, really good for explanation. For microneedling, we're using either a roller or a microneedling pen. So what I have been using for about 1 year, it's Dr. Pen Ultima A6. Now this works perfectly. It is older generation. There is maybe another 3 or 4 models out already. And they using single use cartridges like this one. This one is 36 pins, 36 needles. I have been really, really happy with this pen. Basically, microneedling devices are poking really quickly holes into your face. So, by poking the holes in your face, it is creating a micro injury, and that helps to jumpstart new collagen production. With roller, it's always a little bit slower, and with the roller, actually the wound is in the like a V shape, because as the needle goes in and go out, so it's really more like a little bit damaging. And microneedling pen is more like a swing machine, so it goes up and down, and create a straightforward down holes in your face, I suppose. And you can do it in different depths for different purposes. For example, for like fine wrinkles and stuff, it's from 0.5 to 1. So all the dermatologists will caution you and told you not to go deeper than 0.5 millimeters. It's because through our face, it's go like we have facial nerves. I'm not sure where now. I'm just showing willy-nilly. Anyway, so we have facial nerves on our face, and if you go and use the device and you poke too deep, or you poke the nerve, then you can end up with partial paralyzed face, which is not fun, and then you need to go to plastic surgeons to try to help you. So this is why you shouldn't go deeper than 0.5 millimeters at home. Another one is skin infection if you're not careful enough. So we'll get in details all about the dangers, I suppose, what you need to know before you even start thinking to do anything with your face. Microneedling is used both in clinical and aesthetic practice. It was developed by a German dermatologist, and now it is used for treatments of fine lines, wrinkles, skin texture, pore size, hyperpigmentation but not melasma, then what else, treating of acne scars. So there is wide range of use for microneedling today, and it's growing popularity more and more. And I must say, it's my absolute favorite too. A little bit painful, but really, really good. Let's talk about a little bit about microneedling and actives. So many women, they like to, during the microneedling, use different serums. I don't know, with vitamin C, peptide serum, many different ones. But they don't know that could be really a problem, because microneedling is not used in aesthetic practice very long, and there are simply not enough studies what will happen if you microneedle deep inside the skin some ingredients. So for example, there have been some studies, some positive and some negative studies about microneedling and tretinoin, which is vitamin A, like retinoic acid, and it was really positive result for the acne scar treatment. You can find the, I will put the link in the description box for this study, so you can check it out for yourself. So there was a positive one. Another positive one was microneedling combining with minoxidil. Minoxidil is used for the hair growth, and microneedling is also a treatment for the hair growth for alopecia patients as well. So there was really good results there as well, and you can find the link to the study in the description box again. But a very negative one happened for some women when they were microneedling with vitamin C serum, which is extremely popular. I saw it everywhere. They even selling devices together with vitamin C serum, like a combo. And these women had adverse reaction, foreign body granuloma, which is basically, in like simple explanation, if you get a splinter in your finger, the immune system will react to it and will make a tissue surround that piece of wood, so it protects, so the body is protected against from it. So basically it happened with vitamin C, that body reacted a weird way, and it started surrounding that vitamin C molecules with the tissue, and these women, they had really like a sort of rashes and a little bit bumpy, I presume bumpy skin, but probably like the rashes, and this thing is permanent. So I really caution you to don't go put whatever you think is good for you, and stick to basics, which was proven that it's safe. And so, for example, use hyaluronic acid serum, pure hyaluronic acid serum for the face to create the slip for the device. And very simple fragrance-free moisturizers afterwards for aftercare, and daytime use mineral sunscreen only to protect the skin from the sun damage. So this is one scary thing. I know, like today I'm probably gonna scare you off not to start microneedling, but I mean, you have to know all the risk if you want to do it by yourself. That's why the doctors or beauty aestheticians, they don't want you to do it at home, because it can, you know, it doesn't have to end up well. Well, another thing is the medicine can interact with the skin and cause some problems. For example, steroids are very it's not popular use. They use for many different kind of patients, like psoriasis. Like I have psoriasis, so I need to be careful with that. For eczema, dermatitis, and specifically topical steroids. If you use, on the face, and you will microneedle later, can cause problem, because steroids, they masking signs of infection in the skin. So, for example, if you had psoriasis in your cheek, on your cheek, and you were using steroid creams for a couple weeks, now it's gone and you want to microneedle, you can develop skin infection and not really notice it in the beginning, because steroid will cover that signs. And you should wait a few weeks until the skin get to the normal levels. Many patients, they take steroids orally. That can also cause the problem, the same problem. It will mask the signs of infection. So you need to think about it and be very careful. Another medicine you should be careful is isotretinoin. It is a strong vitamin A treatment for acne. So you need to talk with your dermatologist before you try microneedling by yourself. Another dangerous one is aspirin. Because if you take aspirin, it's not just painkiller, but it's also thinning your blood. And as I mentioned before, microneedling is basically poking needles in your face, so you can start bleeding or bruise really severely. A few rules about microneedling is that we do not microneedle ever on active acne. So if you have pimples, you cannot microneedle over it, because you can introduce bacteria into it and it will be really, really bad for you. As I mentioned before, melasma. If you have psoriasis or rash or eczema, also you cannot touch that skin at that point. So you need to wait until your skin is clear and doesn't have broken skin, no acne, no any rash. It must be really in good condition before you start microneedling. If you have very dark skin tone, you need to be really, really careful. Because the darker skin you have, the more prone to hyperpigmentation you are. And I'm just not sure if at home microneedling is for you, because you need to use melanin inhibitors prior several weeks prior to treatment. And I'm just simply not sure if the risk is worth for you. And I would do it only in professional settings. So just to make sure you will not create more problems to your skin. Hygiene is super important. You need to make sure that you are disinfecting everything you will touch. So you need to prepare the setting, put your tools, disinfect them. Any bottles or creams you will touch, you should disinfect them as well. You should wear gloves or you need to clean your hands really thoroughly, and I wash my hands with soap, and then I usually also spray with alcohol, so I'm make sure that it's all clean. So with microneedling pen, I like that there is a disposable cartridges, like I showed you before, this one, so you don't need to worry about that and disinfect it again. These are sterile already. But with roller, you need to disinfect it before and after use as well, just to make sure that you're not introducing any bacteria or viruses to your skin and cause very nasty infection. And I know some women, they would use witch hazel, but witch hazel is not disinfection, so you need to use proper disinfection for your skin. And so any basically area you planning to microneedle, face, neck, chest, hands, legs, anything, you need to wipe with the disinfectant before you start microneedle. Another question you might ask, how often should you microneedle? Well, it depends of your healing rate, but it's between 3 to 8 weeks. So after treatment, you might have some reaction or you might not. You might have some peeling or you might not. So it really depends of person to person and their skin, how they will react. If you just start with microneedling, it will take about 6 sessions to see any improvements on your skin. And it also will last the results for another 6 months after the procedures. But the effects will not last forever, because our own skin biology, The collagen will help was helped produce by microneedling will eventually break down probably about 9 months. So in order to keep the best results, you should basically microneedle indefinitely. And that is why I love it to use it at home, because I can do it myself. The office treatment is really expensive in many countries. So I find that this particular treatment, if you do it right and safe, you can have really lifelong good results and benefits from it. Enough with the theory, and let's see how it's done. Hi, so you cannot see, but down underneath the camera I set up small table with all the things I need for microneedling. And I have clean and disinfect everything I will be touching, so I will be not wearing gloves today, but everything has been thoroughly disinfected. Each bottle I will touch, the tools, the bowl with the hyaluronic acid, so everything has been properly cleaned. I will be using today, this is Dr. Pen. So I do recommend to change cartridge for each section of your body you plan to microneedle, because the needle is getting blunt quite easy. Next one is my little ball with hyaluronic acid inside and brush, and this everything was clean and disinfected. This is the hyaluronic acid serum I'm using. This is just pure hyaluronic acid serum by Cosmetica Skincare. I got this one from iHerb, but it's also available on Amazon, I'm pretty sure. So I use this one always for microneedling, just pure hyaluronic acid. And aftercare, just use this fragrance-free QV cream moisturizer. I'm using this one I got in Slovakia, so probably you won't understand anything, but it's basically disinfection meant for direct use on skin. And would be more optimal to use gauze than cotton pad, because you don't want bits and pieces stuck on your face, but unfortunately I do not have. So let's see, and this is the most uncomfortable part, because it's alcohol on your face. So the first I will use the nano cartridge. All these cartridges are only one use, so you have to dispose it after use. As I mentioned before, it nano goes only up to 0.25 millimeters. It cannot go deeper, and you're supposed to be able to use it weekly. But for me, it's, I don't know how, like I'm quite a germaphobe, and the disinfection and preparation is quite even for me, so I can't imagine to do it on a weekly basis, but definitely you can. You need to set the pen on zero. There is a tiny little arrow here, so you point it on zero and you put the cartridge in, and just hold the this little button for a few seconds and will turn on. So generally the faster the needle goes is less painful. I don't use any numbing agents when I microneedle. I don't think it's for myself, for me it's not necessary. It is a little bit painful, slight discomfort, but I wouldn't bother with the numbing cream. For somebody who's more sensitive, go ahead, use the numbing cream. But don't forget, you need to wash the numbing cream properly, disinfect the face. So this you do to create a slip on the skin so you don't drag it. I don't know. So actually I put it now on 2 millimeters, but it just lift up that inner part, which is now is touching my face. can see it's getting red. So I do not bleed. Some say like, oh, you must bleed so you have any benefits from microneedling. I don't think so. So if you used roller, you don't need to put hyaluronic acid, and actually it's better because you can grab the skin, pull it, and you can microneedle, so it's better effect. But with the hyaluronic acid, it's like sleeping. It doesn't hurt at all, this one. So you can either do up and down motions and then cross, but I like a more circular motion. So skin around the eyes is really thin and very sensitive. So never go more than 0.25 millimeters around the eyes, and obviously don't go too close to the eyeball. You should pull the skin a little bit downwards when you work this area like this. Let's change the cartridge because I'm not sure if I'm loving this one. This is a 36 needles pin. So again, I need to go to zero. So when you put it in, it shouldn't needle sticking out, right? It needs to go down. And let's set it to 0.5. So I'm done. As you can see, I have nice pink tone. I have a little bit more hyaluronic acid, and before I start do the rest of my neck and chest, I'll apply cream so my face doesn't get too dry. Because you know how hyaluronic acid works. If you don't put something to stop it to go out, it will pull the water out and you will end up with dry skin. So let's put the moisturizer on. So once you're done, it feels like sunburn. The pinkness goes away in a few hours. The next day, basically fine, unless it's done professionally in a doctor's office or in beautician salon. They go much deeper, so the downtime of healing might be a little bit longer. I mean, I love microneedling. I have been doing now for like 1 year, and I can see really the difference. I had starting having here very fine lines. They're gone. The pore size improved, especially here. I mean, this is like, you can do it yourself. I mean, really carefully, but you can do it yourself. And once you invest to the on pen and the cartridges, it lasts really long. With rollers, it's problem that you need to, you can use it max 3 times, and in between use, you need to sterilize the roller. So that's why I prefer the pen, because you put the cartridge in, then when you need a new one, you just use the new one. And as I said before, the needle's getting blunt, so well, you should honestly use the roller for like a one use only, but you can use it technically up to 5 times. Alright, let's see. And for the neck, the skin on the neck is also thinner, so you don't really need to go very deep. I only go deeper a little bit on these horizontal lines. With the microneedling, the deeper you go, the more painful it is. So if you, for example, thinking to do a microneedling treatment for your acne scars, that you should do with dermatologist, definitely not by yourself, because you need to go very deep, 2 millimeters up to 3 millimeters. They need to use a numbing agent, because otherwise it's too painful. And once you're done with everything and it's daytime, you should use mineral sunscreen. Mineral because zinc oxide is usually less irritating, so that's why. Yes, yeah, so that should not happen to jump up. Jump out like this, that cartridge goes straight to bin. Are you gonna jump? And the bones is true. I don't want to do it too much. Alright, so that's done. Let's put some cream on. And that's it. So now you don't want to touch your face and obviously the rest of the body for some time.
Well, this is all for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy my video, please subscribe, like, share, and hit that notification bell so you can see all my future videos. Ciao, ciao! See you next time!